I am a hot mess. Luckily, like my hair is the only thing that's really like on point today. Just got home from grocery store and thrifting, and my room's a disaster. So I'm gonna chat. You can stitch or go about doing your business. Just listen to me, and I'll let you know when I show some cool shit. Great? Awesome. I hope you guys have been well. It is a lovely day here in Arizona. It's finally warming up. Thank goodness. Now, when you're like, oh, well, it's not like it really gets cold. Well, it gets cold to me, okay? Like, if it's like under 70, give me like a sweater. So, that's just how I am. I'm a total wuss. But it's supposed to be getting nice. So I'm all for that. People are in town for spring break or the spring break, spring training games. That's a really popular thing to do on the weekends, especially with the weather getting so nice. The night games sell out super quick. They have lawn seats that are like $20, and a lot of people go with families. And the kids can play on the grass while the parents can drink booze and watch a game if they're so interested. I've been good, just busy. With the boys, spring break is next week. I will include. Okay, time to look. I'm gonna insert a picture of how far the guest room flooring is. Looks super nice, changes the room entirely. It's slow, tedious work, but it's looking fantastic. All right, you can go back to whatever you were doing. Been going to the attic for Thursday night stitch-ins, which are amazing. If you live in the Arizona area where you can make it down to the attic, I strongly recommend the store. Tell Jean I sent you. But the stitch-ins on Thursday, so much fun. Great group of ladies. It's just awesome. So, no, these are not patterns. So yeah, I've been going to the stitch-ins, and I went last Thursday. I bought some stuff, so I'll show you that. What else? Thrift store. Have I showed you this? Maybe it was in a, must have been in a live IG video. So that's it. I think that's all I've worked on. So let me show you guys. All right. Oh, actually, okay. A few weeks ago, I met Lynn and her husband. They came into the attic because we chatted back and forth, and I told her I would be there. She wanted to meet me, and I wanted to meet her. So here is a photo of Lynn and I. Super cute, super nice. So thank you, Lynn. And it was great meeting you and your husband and chit-chatting with you. Let's do thrift store. A couple weeks ago, I found a good amount of punch needle patterns, which I've already sent out. for some punch needle kindness. Then I have these Christmas quilt blocks that were also a part of the bag that I found. So I'm thinking about putting these up on my Amazon store. Some are embroidery, Americana. This is wooden spool designs. It's cute. Mulberry folk art. And some of these are duplicates. I have, but it's like a wool applique. So a lot of Americana ones. And then small shoulder bag punch needle patterns. And it shows you how to make the bag as well. So I got to get those listed. I got a lot of stuff that I need to list in this bag as well. Hiding in there, there were four gentle arts threads. They're not, these three are full dried thyme and chamomile, and this one's been used, but it was like, what, $4.50 for these, some punch needle ones, and the thread, which it's like $4.50 just for the thread. Done. Sign me up. What else? I had also found this awesome clock. You guys, I don't know what it is with clocks. Like, I keep finding them to do stuff. Well, that one I saved. And then the one that I took out all the insides and framed. I love how thick this is and the design on the wood. So this lives up in my closet of frames. It's getting ridiculous because now I'm stacking them. So I just need to finish and stitch. Well, I would say I don't need to finish more because I finish all of my stuff, but I need to stitch more. I remember standing here, I had a question. In my last video, somebody asked how I store my patterns. So I have magazine racks. This one just happens to be metal. You can find them at, I find them at the thrift store all the time. This one I hold my X-Stitch magazines. Are you guys getting a subscription of this? It's pretty fabulous. I mean, it's not pretty, it's very fabulous. Look into it. So this is where I keep those. We got all my charts. I have charts that I haven't stitched. These. The middle one is charts that I have kitted up. Now, not fully kitted. Maybe I have the chart with the intended fabric or a chart with the threads pulled. And then the last one is all my finished charts that I'm holding on to. And I will go through those, like when I did my selling, my de-stash, I went through those. But there's some that I'm just not willing to sell right now. A lot of Prairie Moons. My Nightmare. So, because that's an out-of-print one. But, yeah, this is how I store them. When they get full, then I'll just have to get another one. But, yeah, this is just how. I don't alphabetize them, categorize them, or organize them by designer or anything like that. So how I do it. Another chart that will be There's a sal, and I don't know why. I want to say it's another birthday sal. I don't know how I keep getting roped into these birthday sals. Michelle Bendy's, I'll show you guys that. But there's going to be a sal for Frida. So, Michelle, you need to talk about it. Hopefully, you talk about it in your today's video because it's Tuesday. Enough said. So, Danielle sent me the magazine so I can get my Frida on. And I absolutely love it. They gave her the unibrow. Oh, it's just, excuse me, it's just wonderful. And I love that it's in this crazy gold ornate frame. So this will definitely be a start soon. So finishes. Michelle's birthday, she decided she wanted to do a stitch along Garden of Eerie. Oh look, I have it. Plum Street samplers. It's kind of a play off of like an Adam and Eve sampler. I did this on 36 count, 2 over 2 DMC. This fabric was gifted to me, so I'm not sure what the color. It's an off. And I finished it last night. Now, those of you that have never stitched it might be like, oh great, it's finished. There was another cloud here. I was over it. I had stitched like all of that in a week. And I was gonna just leave it without the tree and the vulture, but I needed something. It didn't look complete. I tried it in different frames. It needed the tree. So the storm is passing. That's why there's none over here. The storm's passing. Finished it on a canvas, just a regular painter's canvas. Nothing crazy. I just need to cut off this excess. I stapled this last night. But yeah, I don't have it padded with anything. Now, you might be like, this isn't straight. I know. I meant to do it like that because no ground is perfectly straight. And I kind of want it to look like, to me, it coming up more look like, kind of like roots of trees. How they tend to be a little bubbled at the base. So I love it. There was an additional part down here. It said this work rot, ROT by, but I decided I didn't want to add that. But yeah, this is my Garden of Eerie. I love the cloud, with the three different greens. It's just amazing. She's fantastic. I don't know what else to say. The flower has a face on it. Frank looks pissed, you know. When you first look at this, you kind of think like the bird is humping the dog. But no. Thanks, Paula. But no, love this. So I gotta trim up the back, sign it, and hang it. Oh, another thing at the thrift store. Necklace. Nope. I'm gonna be able to make it into a needle minder, which is awesome. All right. What else? So I got that done. Garden of Eerie. What else have I worked on? Oh. So then I set aside The Master and the Macabre, Cricut collection. Everyone's been going crazy for it. I want to say Maui Jen, did you get your copy of 123? I can't remember. You can find it though.
Again, I'm super close.
Super close.
Smart progress. I'm using DMC. This is periwinkle on a 30 count, 2/2. And I love how the colors are. Now, in my last video, I talked about the moon, that I was going to do the moon not in white, because everyone knows white stitches look like shit. So, I had in my stash, I didn't have silver white petite treasure braid. This is a very fine number 4 braid, Krynek Metallic. Has shine to it. It works. I didn't want the sparkle to be over the top. But that is what I have done for the moon and will continue to do for the moon. So there's sparkle in it, but it's not distracting. So that's what I love about it. So I will definitely get back to this because this can be a finish. But I have now needing to kind of turn my attention away from working on finishes. Whoa, almost lost it there. To a gift for my friend, and he's going to be giving this to his sister. So I don't do works. But he is an artist himself with music, and I would totally do this for him. I'm going to insert a picture of what the final product will look like. You can get this at So Flossy Flossy. I will link Nicole Hume, the Etsy store below. It's the Life Aquatic, the Wes Anderson movie. It has all the characters, obviously, and that is where I'm at. I'm stitching this on a 14 count blueberry Ada, and it's just weird working on Ada because the holes are so defined. I don't know, it's just strange to me. So one set of legs, but I want to get this done just so it's not finish me, and I do want to do it. So that is what I plan to be working on basically till it's done. I don't need to send it to him till like the beginning of the month, so I have a little time. But what I did work on for the yesterday, I had to, my LDS Virtue. I have all of that completed, the first three pages. And now I'm working on page 4 right here. And that's where I am. My crazy OCD will not let me start on the words. So I'm going to do the border and then work. But that's okay because the wording was starting out here and I did not feel comfortable enough counting out that far, so I'll just finish up page 4 of the border and then start moving on. Love these colors. You guys tell me all the time the colors are amazing. I'm just using the DMC, and this will be a fair entry this year. Yes, I'm gonna get it done, people, and I'm gonna get it done and take it to Jersey. Not framed, obviously, but it will be there, done. I want to work towards that goal. Don't have long before Jersey, so I better get my crap together. Luckily, though, 4, 5, and 6, the pages, it's obviously just the flower border and this writing. So basically, it's cheating. 3 of the pages don't count. But then I got this down here, and this is going to be a mother. And look, Letitia. I got some cocks. Letitia. I know they're the male cock, the peacocks. The male peacocks are the ones with the flowers. But Letitia. It's a Joe and Joe. So. Love this. So I will be going between my commission piece and Virtues for the time being. Now, what else? What else do I have to show? I got gifts? Oh, let's do Attic. Where did I get it? Attic. When I was there a month or so ago, Jean came over to the table where I was stitching and showed their latest 57 count fabric. Correct. 5, 7. I was doing a live Instagram video. People went WTF. Then Cassie and I were talking. And we got a kind of a hair up our butt that we kind of wanted to start 57. So they had, I found some 52. It's 52 by 60. Holy God, those holes are small. I mean, everyone wants a small hole, but that's kind of like crazy. Lynn saved me because I was looking for the higher counts. I found a 46 count Vintage Fawn Lakeside. This is going to be my testing piece. Do I like working on 46? Is it going to drive me batshit S? So nothing crazy, a 12 by 16 piece, but I want to do my LDS, my next one, because you only have one LDS going on at a time. Don't tell Cassie that. It's the Opus one. I want to do it on a higher count fabric. And I want to cheat. I only want to do a half stitch. But I want to make sure that the coverage is still good. So I'm going to see. I'm going to find a small chart, do half stitch, 46, 1 over 2, and see how I like it. If it's manageable, I'll use 46 on my LDS. I did 40 for Nightmare, but you can't do a half stitch on 40. And I'm cheating and I don't want to do a full X. So hopefully in my next video, I will have a little progress to show you something for this 46 count. I'm thinking doing like my first small pillow, maybe like a Halloween chart, something not crazy. So I'll get back to you on that. And clearance bin at Attic is amazing. My OCD went crazy and I had to reorganize all of the charts because they were bent, were out of, some were standing, some were laying down. But it gave me a great opportunity to go through the charts. I found a couple for some friends and sent them off. I found this one from Waxy Moon Designs, Primitive Bouquet. I thought it was cute. $5. Actually, no. Was it at half off of this? I think that was $2.50. Then when I was... Gosh darn carriage house saplings. They get you every time. The gilded cage. I think it's the colors. Kind of this ruby, raspberry, red, the greens. I think it's super cool. So I picked that up. $7. That was not in the clearance. That was on just the thing. This is what I got today. Came home from the store. I texted her that I should have probably worn these. Cassie, did you even, like, you wore these, like, once? You guys, look. Now I'm getting shoes. Screw stitching stuff. Fabric. Charts. You wear, like, what size are these? 9? Heels? You didn't really wear a whole lot? Hit me up. They're like a grayish green. Shit. I'm wearing them in my video now. Love these. Peep toe. Done. So thanks, Cassie. So now I'm getting people sending me shoes. Awesome. The wonderful Kathleen's Trotted Trail. You guys watch her stuff? She does punch needle. She finishes her stuff into pillows. I'm gonna link her down below. If you're not watching Kathleen, what are you doing with your life? She sent me the most amazing box of goodies. Lovely card chocolates, which I'm surprised the boys haven't come in here and rifled through them. My first ever Stitch Dot needle minder. Super cute. This is totally me because it's a pumpkin guy riding a black bird. Raven that's wearing a witch hat. Scissors, which are lovely and heavy, and then I took them out and put on the little scissor fob that she also included. You guys, look, it's a heel. First ever Lizzie Kate spooky eyes. Super cute. Love the fabric as well. Shit, I could stitch that up before dinner. Piece of 40 count murky. I love me some murky. I was stitching, arsenic and old lace on it. I think murky is just amazing. Then, I was blown away by this. She has stitched that, you guys. Anchored it in this tin. Oh, I see it's a David's Tea tin. Filled it with the beads. Flower, ribbon. It's gorgeous. I love this. I'm going to hang this on my curio that I have all my fabric in. Super cute. And then these charts, yes, first ever Madame Chantilly chart. I love this. I've totally been eyeing this and just had never gotten it. It's amazing. It's so cool. Her charts are awesome, very whimsical and unique. Witch board. I actually already have this, but this will definitely come in handy for a giveaway for in the future. And I want to start this too. I need to stitch more. Then this, like, Joe was blown away. He went through the box and saw everything. And he mentioned that he thought this was pretty cool. Nevermore. It's by Michelle Inc. Needlework Designs. It's from 07. It's, I love the book in the background, on the skull, with the tipped over ink. Yeah, ink bottle, candle. The candle is awesome. It has all that variegated color on it. This would look awesome burnt. So, thank you, Kathleen. Now I can put all my stuff away, because you can't use anything, you can't eat anything until you show it on your video. So thank you, love. And you have a package coming that I sent out in the mail today. Like I said earlier, I went thrifting before I went grocery shopping this morning. I took some video, and I'm going to add that video in here. Hello! I thought I would take you guys along and show you the store where I find fabulous finds. White Dove Thrift Store. It's hospice-based, so I love that the money goes back into the nonprofit. Let's go see what goodies I can find. I love this old hamper. Super cute. And then I love that they kind of separate, like, the really vintage clothes from everything else. They have, like, a Girl Scouts uniform. This one, I think's pretty incredible. Let me see if I can... So, they have it listed... Vintage Young Child's Garment, $16.60, $18.80. The buttons are just incredible. And then this dress is definitely handmade. I mean, there's a hole here, but it's gorgeous and it's long. I just don't know what I would wear it for. And this is where I find a lot of hand-stitched, cross-stitched pieces. And they're, you know, super reasonable. $3, and today it was either 25 or 50% off all collectibles. And that's everything with a C that's circled. So I'll look through here and see if I can find any goodies. And this is like the clearance area, and they always have really cool vintage items, toys, baseball cards, Viewmaster, vintage postcards, $1 each. Kind of the smaller things, spoons, thimbles. $8. Yeah, I might be getting those. It's half off. But they always have cool stuff. Oh my god, I totally remember those. Flip up. This chair's kind of amazing too. And then these hats were just in a few weeks ago. That one's pretty amazing. And gloves. And yeah,
should bring the small hats back with the veils. And then these are pretty cool, the tie bars and cufflinks. Do I need a flask for one of the retreats? I might. And then what's this? Early 1900s. This is $90. Beaded bag with early 20th century. And it looks like this used to be all covered in beads, but it's all off. Pretty amazing. So this kind of totally goes with my outfit for the day. I just paired it with a simple shirt, but it totally goes though, super cute. They also have real furs, which I'm against, but I would, they're pretty amazing, especially this one. I've always admired this one. It's more just like a little capelet. And this one is gorgeous because it has pockets. They're obviously on the spendy side, but they're gorgeous. Look, we could have twinsies, somebody. Let's be twinsies. Now, tell me honestly, would this be too much? It's too much. It is fantastic. OMG, you guys. It's perfect. I don't even think it's been worn. $50. Oh, shoulder pads. It's pretty spectacular. A lot of these are larger, so they definitely don't fit. That's cute, just like sloppy. I've tried this one on, but it's too big. Okay, never mind. I'm gonna show up at the retreat in this. I'll be in my sequin room in here. This is pretty amazing. Do you think this shirt is too ridiculous? I mean, it's kind of fabulous in a bright color sort of way. And it's this Adriana, which I have, I don't know how many of her sequin jackets. It's kind of fabulous. This is another favorite spot of mine. It's kind of like the craft area, and they've got all kinds of stuff. Yarn and more yarn and ribbon, and they have miscellaneous stuff and cuts of fabric, and then like just kind of like miscellaneous stuff like an M, Q. Yeah, I always like going through here and seeing what I can find. Back here is like where they have furniture, and when Elena and I get old, these are the chairs we're gonna stitch in, because they're everything. I mean, really? And they rock? This is us. $21 and 2 bags. Not bad. Found some good stuff in that place, as always. I love coming and checking this place out every couple weeks. They have pretty good turnaround, and there's always people coming by and donating. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the little trip with me, and now I will show you guys what I got. I passed on the spools of thread. The collectibles were only 25% off. It was $8 for those. I gotta show you this. Okay, I'll show you that after. I got enough spools. I got spools up the yin yang. So I passed on those, but this is what I got. You always need a hat here in Arizona, especially with boat season coming. I know it doesn't really work on the hair, but I got super cute hat. My other hard one got wet at the pool last year, so now it's like
floppy and stuff. But I love this fabric around. And then in the back, there's this pop of pink. Summer Club, styled in Australia. Protect against skin cancer. I love this, though. Cute boat hat. Or, like, wannabe Michael Jackson. So. Got that. And I have all these skirts that are, like, knee length. Like, kind of like pencil skirts. I'm finding all these vintage ones. Because you can't always look like a hoe. I mean, you gotta... When you go out, like when I go out with girlfriends and stuff, that's one thing. But sometimes you just need like a nice, classy pencil skirt. This one's a little longer. Super cute. What won me though? Look at this. Elena. Look at this. Look at this pleating for this like little peekaboo in the back. It's pleated. Super cute. And I love the black and red. I think it's really sexy. So, pair of, like, high heels. I'll have to get my taser for Joe. Then, Steve Madden heels, brand new, never worn, $8, yes. So they, like, wrap around your ankle. They're super cute. So that's what I got. Now, earlier in the week, I had gone thrifting. Now, those that go thrifting, you know that feeling you get? You're driving by, you're at the house. Should I go thrifting? Shouldn't I? I kind of feel like it. I haven't been there. You know that feeling you get? It's called TST, Thrift Store Tingle. Okay? I know Michelle wants to call it McKenna Tingle. My mind just goes to the gutter with that. So the PG version is TST. It sounds like something like you need cream to clear up, but in this case, don't try to find a cure for it. This I found. This was an early thrift store find from the hospice place. Cosmetic box, but I didn't have anywhere to put my goodies, so I just threw them in here, and it fits. So, let me show you what I all got, a little bit of everything, for, is it like $6, $7, Arlene? I can't remember. I did a walkthrough with Arlene. The greatest pin cushion, which to me, when I saw this pin cushion, I thought of Mary Rose. It's from the 1960s. And I love that. I don't know if this is the original thimble because it says gold thimble scotch on it. But this is how the little prong here is for your thimble to be. And then I didn't realize this. I was like, oh, what's this weird tab? Yes. So, and then I found the older one. I also picked up, or in the bag, a ton of wooden spools. Couple dozen. Thread on them, star linen, star nylon, Coats and Clarks. I love that they still have the thread on them. The ones that I, you know, put into my good intentions, I could put in some of these colored ones, but I kind of want to do a stitching chart that has something to do with sewing, and then Arlene gave me the idea then to use like all these great vintage Notion pieces and kind of
sneak in there. So,
these I'm gonna put in with my Plague Doctor frame, but these were in there. These I just are super cool. Little metal shears. Just so you'll remember, Anthony Wayne Bank, Fort Wayne, Indiana.
And it's a sewing little kit to go.
I love how this stuff even smells like all like musty and old. And again, you know, finding all these great things, I always wonder who owned all these. What happened to them? Pair of peaking shears from the Wise, Newark, New Jersey, and then some bigger ones as well. And you can tell, like, these are the old ones with the black handles. Screwdriver, because in case I never ever need to defend myself, and it's classy because it's black and gold. All kinds of hooks and clasps. Vintage buttons and rickrack, bias tape, all kinds of old needles, Betsy Ann, 25 cents. Weaving needle. I just like the packaging, it's just what's awesome. And of course, I was destined to get this huge lot of sewing stuff. Look, vintage sequins that probably belong to some amazing shirt or jacket. I mean, look at those colors. Again, a ton of buttons, variety of buttons. It used to be that men would needle women who smoked in public. You've come a long way, baby. We hope you enjoy this assortment of quality sewing and darning needles, compliments of New Virginia Slims. Okay. Do I look as fabulous as her, though, if I smoke? I don't think I do. What else? This Singer accessory box. There were more needles in here. As well as a U.S. Army badge with one of the little shoulder emblem. Again, who did this patch belong to? Husband? A son? What war? All things I think about. Thimbles and a pair of those cool scissors that, what are these? Slip and snip? They pull out. These ones are the legit ones, though. They're all metal and heavy. See? No, it's not blood. It's just, I think it's like nail polish. So, yeah. Pretty amazing. That's all I have for you guys. That's it. That's all I have to show. It was a lot. I thank you guys for watching and listening in. I hope to have some progress. I'm interested on the 46 count. I'm super excited to do that and kind of see how that works out. And hopefully, if it's enjoyable for me and easy enough for me, you guys too will want to up your count. Or you'll just leave that craziness for me. That's totally fine as well. Thank you guys so much for always watching. Make sure to subscribe. Can follow me on Instagram, Stitching in Sequins, and then I have my second Instagram page, Thrifting in Sequins, where I post thrifted outfits that I wear for the day or photos from the thrift store or things that I have bought. Have a fantastic day, you guys, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.